Well, good morning, saints of the Most High God. Truly, this is the day that the Lord has made, and we are rejoicing, and we are all glad in it. This is Apostle David Davis from the Greater Life Church in Lakewood, Washington, and I greet everybody with divine love and Jesus joy. As always, it is a privilege, a pleasure, and an honor to be connected with all God's lovely, awesome, wonderful, magnificent people. I thank God for you. Good morning to Keisha. God bless you. Thank you so much for being on the broadcast this morning. Thank you so much for your faithfulness and dedication to the broadcast and to the mission of Greater Life. I appreciate you and your family. Everybody that's getting on, please leave a greeting. Leave a greeting so that I can acknowledge you. I want to acknowledge you and tell you how much I appreciate you and how very special you are to me and to God, number one. Good morning to Carol. God bless you. Thank you so much for getting on. Look, this is to Facebook. Facebook, we do not own the rights to this music, so please don't mute my video. I do not own the rights to this music. We're just playing this music for the listening pleasure of the saints to get our broadcast going and off the ground. Good morning to Katrina Arnold. God bless you. Thank you so much for being on. Thank you so much for your faithfulness and agreeing to pray on next month at 6 a.m. Here's a little music just to get us going, to welcome everybody in. And as we prepare for the day's broadcast, God bless everybody this morning. Good morning to Mother Sam, Dad Sam. God bless you. I really appreciate you guys getting on. Thank you so much, Dad and Mom Sam, for your prayers on Wednesday morning on the prayer line. We really appreciate you guys. And we thank God for your faithfulness to the Lord. Look, I am so grateful to all of my partners and my parishioners. I am so grateful to have you in my life, amen. You make doing ministry, amen, delightful, amen. You make doing ministry, amen, easy. And I thank God for you guys. You guys have been just stellar in every way. And there's no way we can do ministry effectively without you. You are a part of the kingdom vision that God is doing through Greater Life. So thank you so much for everybody. So come on, let's share the broadcast. Let's get everybody in here. Amen. Let's lift our hands in total adoration to the Lord. Yes. Yes, he reigns on the throne. Hallelujah. Yes, he is. God alone. Good morning to Pastor D. I think you're on this morning. Good morning to Diane. It's always a pleasure to see you, Diane. Good morning to my sister. God bless you. Thank you, sis, for your wonderful prayers on Tuesday morning on the prayer line. Good morning to Ruth. God bless you. Good morning to Sonia. God bless you. Look, all of my Greater Life members, I want to see you in service on this Sunday. We're going to release an exciting series called Family Affair, and I believe it's going to bless you and your family, not just your conventional family, but it's going to bless the church family as well. So I pray that everybody, amen, will come on in and be a part of the worship services. They're going to be phenomenal. Hallelujah. Thank you, everybody, being part of the 6 a.m. prayer. Are you a part of the 6 a.m. prayer? I'm telling you, it is powerful. Your life will not be the same. So this morning, we're excited about God. Come on, let's tell the Lord that we love him. Yes. Yes. It's one of my favorite songs. Yes, that I love you. Yes. How many of you love Jesus? Come on, let's talk to him this morning. I love you, Jesus. Yes, I worship and adore you. I just want to say thank you. Come on, you got to tell him thank you for yourself. Yes, more than anything. Do you love Jesus more than anything, more than yourself? Yes, more than money. More than physical possessions. Yes. More than people. Yes. Yes. I just want to tell you that I love you, Lord. Yes. Yes. Come on. You got to make that declaration. Lord, I love you more than anything. Yes. Yes. I worship you. Come on, let's take some time to worship him. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Is that the sentiments of your heart that you love Jesus? Come on. Come on, worship will get you through. Yes. Yes, Lord. Yes, I love you, Lord. More than anything. Yes. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Yes, amen. That is our declaration. That is, amen, our heart, that we love Jesus more than anything. Greetings, everybody. Again, I'm so appreciative of you being on the broadcast this morning. Look, I want to remind you that on this coming Wednesday, we're going to be consecrating again. Yes, again. And I'm getting tremendous testimonies from people as a result of their consecration. Consecration is when we set aside time for some focus, intense prayer, worship, and fellowship with the Lord. It's when we give him our undivided attention because we want to draw closer to him in fellowship, because we want to hear his voice, we want to know his will, and we want to be obedient to what he wants us to do. And during our time of consecration, we are fasting and praying. You can fast in any way the Holy Spirit directs you. You can do an absolute fast, no food, no drink, or you can do a partial fast, just limited to liquids, or you can eat one meal during the fasting period. And again, the fasting period is from 12 a.m. your time to 3 p.m. your time, praise God. But the prayer times will be at 12 a.m. my time on the prayer line, 712-770-4160, access code 979541#. And then again at 6 a.m. my time, 6:55 a.m. my time, praise God, 12 noon my time, and 3 p.m. my time, amen. I feel that God is developing some spiritual momentum in us, praise God. And I believe that God is maturing us. I believe spiritual maturity is taking place. Spiritual momentum is taking place, amen. And then also I believe that we are becoming more stronger, amen, more effective, more fruitful for the Lord, amen. I feel like, amen, that you're going to conquer some things that used to, amen, harass you and torment you, amen. I believe that you're going to flourish in this season of your life. Come on, you're going to flourish in this season of your life. You're getting better. You're getting better because you're growing closer to him. Now, I want to talk and I want to pray. Amen. I want to talk for a few moments about living in the flow. Living in the flow. Good morning to Marquita. God bless you. And we talk about living in the flow. We're talking about living, amen, by and in and through the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Living by, in, and through the power of the Holy Spirit. And we know the Holy Spirit is the third person, amen, of the Trinity, praise God, amen, of the same substance, amen, the same nature, praise God, amen, co-equal with God the Father and God the Son, and they work, amen, harmoniously together. There's no division, there's no schisms, amen, between the three, amen. God eternally existed in three persons, God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is the active agent of the Godhead, amen, that keeps the lines of communication open between us and God, amen. And he empowers us as believers, amen, to live like Christ, amen, and to conquer like Christ, praise God. And so Jesus had these words to say that I want to share with you, amen, in John 7:38. And this is the Amplified Version of the Bible, amen, the Amplified Version of the Bible. And we get these different versions. These versions are just paraphrases that make the scripture more understandable, praise God. Amen. Just, amen, paraphrases of the original text, amen, that makes the scripture more understandable in our English, amen, understanding. Okay. Now, amen, powerful words Jesus said. You know, Jesus was going through a time where he was always on trial by the Pharisees and the Sadducees. They was always trying to catch him. They was always trying to accuse him. They was always trying to persecute him because Jesus was speaking, amen, the word of God, straight from God, in a way that was astonishing the crowd. And it was drawing crowds, amen, to him. And so, amen, the scripture that I want to read is John 7:38. Now, let me set this up. During this time, they were going through the Feast of Tabernacles. And at this particular time in the feast, they will go in the temple and they will take water and pour the water out. This water that they were pouring, it was symbolic of how God brought water from the rock. If you know, remember in Exodus chapter 17, the children of Israel came out of captivity, and when they came out, they were in the desert and they did not have any water. Can you imagine not having water, amen, in the desert? Not having water in the desert. Let me say that again. Well, yes, good morning to Mother Sam. God bless you. I want to make sure I recognize that as well. Good morning and happy birthday to Mother Sam. Hallelujah. God bless you. All right. And so they didn't have any water, and to not have water in the desert meant certain death. Amen. Not having water in the desert meant certain death. And so God supplied water through the rock. He told Moses to go and to speak to a rock, a hard thing, amen, something that wasn't supposed to bring life. But God, amen, through Moses, amen, speaking to the rock, caused water to gush out of the rock, amen, and to quench the thirst of over 1 to 2 million people. Amen. I would say 2 million people. 2 million people's thirst got quenched, amen, because God performed a miracle in a hard, a dry desert place. And I want to just park there for a moment. Amen. You may feel like you're dry. Amen. Some Christians, amen, they allow themselves to get spiritually dry. And becoming spiritually dry could be not necessarily that you have sinned, but you become spiritually dry because you have drifted away from your personal fellowship with God. When you drift away from your personal fellowship with God, amen, you can become spiritually dry. Some Christians, amen, can be going through a spiritual drought. A spiritual drought, amen. What do I mean by that? It's because maybe you have gotten yourself caught up in some type of sin activity, amen. No matter what it is, amen, sin will block the flow of the Spirit in your life, praise God. So no matter whether you are dry because you have drifted from your fellowship with the Lord Jesus, amen, or you are in a drought because maybe you are practicing sin, God can bring you out of that. God can bring you out of that, praise God. Now, amen, Moses, amen, spoke to the rock. Water came from the rock. quench their thirst. Nay, now, this particular ceremony, amen, was symbolic of what God did in the wilderness for the children of Israel. And Jesus, amen, came and he took the water and he poured it out and he cried out to the crowd. He said this, he who believes in me, amen. Here's the amplified version of it. He who believes in me, who cleaves to and trusts in and rely on me, as the scripture has said, from his innermost being shall flow continuously springs and rivers of living water. And what Jesus was saying to the people was, amen, this water, this natural water, amen, is going to run out. But what Jesus is saying, the spiritual water that I give you will run continuously and it will never, ever run out. And what Jesus was talking about was the Holy Spirit. Now, let's go back to the text again. He said, he who believes in me, talking about Jesus, and the word believe means to cleave to. Amen. That's why it's so important. Amen. If you say you believe in Jesus, for you to cleave to Jesus, for you to hold on to Jesus, for you to stay in constant communion, constant intimate fellowship with him. Amen. Because when you start forsaking, amen, your intimate fellowship with Jesus, this is when you start going through a dry spurt in your life. You'll find, amen, your worship becomes dry. You'll find, amen, your walk will become dry. You'll find, amen, praise God, that your prayers become dry. Amen. You'll become dry. Amen. Where you don't feel the life of God flowing through you. It's not that the Spirit is not in you, but it's the fact that you have forsaken your fellowship with him. And you have to realize this, just because you have forsaken your fellowship with him does not mean that he's given up on you. He said, I'll never leave you nor forsake you. So what he starts doing, he starts working, amen, to convict your heart, to bring you back into fellowship with him. Amen. Maybe you're going through a dry spurt right now and you're on this broadcast because the Holy Spirit is using me to speak to you, to tell you to get back to your intimacy with Christ, to get back to your fellowship with Christ, to repent of your sin. Hallelujah. The Bible gives us a covenant promise in 1 John 1:9 that if we confess our faults, if we confess our faults, that he's faithful and just to forgive us and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Don't you listen to the devil. He'll try to keep you in that dry place. You have to understand that demons dwell in dry places. Demons dwell in dry places. When Jesus said, when an unclean spirit is cast out of a man, amen, he go looking, amen, for a place to dwell in, and he dwells in dry places, praise God. And you got to keep that demon in that dry place. And the way you keep that demon in that dry place is that you stay connected to Jesus, the source of living waters, praise God. Hallelujah. You cannot afford to allow your life to become dry of the presence of the living God. You've got to stay in fellowship. You've got to stay in connection. Amen. You've got to stay in the word. Praise God. You've got to stay fellowshipping with other believers. Amen. This keeps you, amen, in the flow of the Spirit of God. Hallelujah. Amen. Sometimes we can quench the Spirit and sometimes we can grieve the Spirit. Amen. Praise God. We can quench the Spirit by forbidding him, amen, to lead and to guide our lives. Amen. There's times that the Holy Spirit is trying to prompt us so that he can bring life in us, so that he can mature us, so that he can grow us, so that he can cause us to become fruitful. And sometimes he prompts us to spend time in prayer. He prompts us to spend time in the word. He prompts us to fellowship with other believers. He prompts us to share Christ with other people. He prompts us, Amen. And the Bible said, as many as are led by the Spirit of God are the sons of God. You have to allow him to lead you, because when he leads you, he keeps you in a place, amen, of fertility. He keeps you in a place of favor. He keeps you in a place of fruitfulness, praise the Lord, where you are not dry, but rivers of living water is flowing out of you. The Holy Spirit is not just a river. The Holy Spirit is rivers, rivers, and rivers, amen, is symbolic of life, symbolic of motion, symbolic of momentum, praise God, symbolic, amen, of the life-giving water of the Holy Spirit that operates inside of a believer, that makes that believer fruitful, that makes that believer passionate, that makes that believer effective, amen, causes that believer to be efficient and operate in excellence and power and authority. You have to live in the flow. Amen. So it says, he that believes in me, who cleaves to me, who trusts in me, hallelujah, amen, amen, and relies on me, as the scripture said, from his innermost being, amen, the flow of God's Spirit reside inside of you, and he lives in the most eternal, intimate place, amen, of your life, your spirit. Your spirit man is the real you. Your spirit man is the eternal you. Your spirit man is the part of you that communicates with God, that has fellowship with God, that has intimacy with God. Amen. Your spirit man is the part of you, amen, where God resides, and he begins to command your thinking, your understanding, your imaginations, your emotions, praise God. He begins to work through your body, where your body becomes a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. When you're living in the flow, amen, you have life, and life more abundantly. Amen. We got to respect the flow. Amen. When I'm talking about respect the flow, I'm talking about respect the presence of the Holy Spirit. Respect the life-giving presence of the Holy Spirit, amen, by partnering with him. Hallelujah. By honoring him, by submitting to him and yielding to his will, not quenching him, amen, and not grieving him, praise God, hallelujah. So the scripture says, amen, from your innermost being shall flow continuously. The Holy Spirit wants to be a continuous flow in your life, and you cannot allow anything to upset, to block the flow of the presence of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Selfishness will block the flow. Fear will block the flow. Pride will block the flow. Worldliness will block the flow. Sin will block the flow. Amen. Carnal friends, amen, will block the flow. Praise God. You cannot allow anything to block the flow. Neglecting your time with God, neglecting your time in the Word will block the flow. Praise God. When the Holy Spirit is flowing in you, you become like a tree planted by the rivers of water, and you start producing fruit. Amen. This is how you know that you are in the flow, because you will produce fruit. Amen. You will produce the fruit of love. You will produce the fruit of joy. You will produce the fruit of peace. You will produce the fruit of goodness. You will produce the fruit of gentleness. You will produce the fruit of self-control. You will produce the fruit, hallelujah, of the Spirit, of long-suffering in your life. Hallelujah. Do you see the fruit? And if you don't see the fruit, amen, you have to ask, am I in the flow? Am I in the flow? I know the flow is in me, but am I in the flow? Am I allowing the flow of the Holy Spirit, amen, to flow freely in my life? Is there some sin in my life that's obstructing the flow? Is there some habit in my life, amen, that's obstructing the flow? Because I don't want anything to hinder the flow, because in the flow there is life and life more abundantly. Are y'all with me today? Amen. You got to receive that flow. If you have not received Jesus, your Lord and Savior, amen, all you have to do is say, Lord, forgive me. I've sinned against you. I'm a sinner. Lord Jesus, come into my heart. Be the Lord of my life from this day forward. As soon as you accept him, the flow of the Holy Spirit lives inside of you, praise God. You receive the flow refreshes you. The flow restores you, regenerates you, and then the flow is released through your life. Are you releasing the flow? When you're releasing the flow, you ought to see, amen, the joy of God in your life. When you're releasing the flow, amen, you bring that joy to others by sharing him with others. You release that flow, amen, through your soul winning. You release that flow through your supplication, your prayer. You release that flow through your service, amen, to God and to others, amen. You release that flow of the Spirit in your life. It was not meant to be just held up inside of you, but it was meant, amen, to flow out of you. Remember, he said, out of your belly, out of your innermost being shall flow rivers of living water. Amen. Life should be flowing through you. The life of God that will change, amen, your spheres of influence. The life of God that will change the life of others. The life of God that will bless others, encourage others, lift others, strengthen others. Amen. Set others free, praise God. Are you living in that flow? Praise God. Hallelujah. If you're not living in the flow, get in the flow, because the flow will bless your life. Now I want to pray as I close this. Amen. I want to pray and pray that we all stay in the flow. Now let me ask this question before I go off. I got a few minutes. Amen. What is your daily life rhythm, your daily life rhythm that keeps you in the flow? Maybe this might help some other people, amen. If you will share your daily life rhythm that keeps you in the flow, amen. Come on, I want to know what yours is. I'll tell you a little bit what mine is, amen. My life rhythm that keeps me in the flow is, amen, that I get up every morning at 5 o'clock. Sometimes it might be a little off. Sometimes it might be a little early, but I get up every morning at 5 o'clock. Amen. I get up, amen. I wash my face. I brush my teeth. Amen. Praise the Lord. I come into this study. Praise God. Amen. Sometimes my regimen may change a little bit. Amen. But my system remains the same. My regimen may change a little bit, but my system remains the same. So my system is to come in here 5 o'clock in the morning. Amen. Either, amen, I am listening to my daily Bible reading, get hooked on the book, praise God. I'm having my time of prayer. I'm on the prayer calls at 6 a.m., 6:55, praise God. I have my own personal time of study, my own personal time of reading. I connect with another preacher, amen, on Tuesdays, amen, and we share out of the book of Revelation, amen. I'm in church when we have church, amen. I have a daily rhythm, a flow that keeps me, amen, in the flow where I stay conscious of the Holy Spirit. I stay connected, amen, to the Holy Spirit, amen, and the Holy Spirit able to flow through my life, amen. I live a lifestyle of repentance. I live a lifestyle of repentance, amen. I'm repenting every day. Praise God, I'm repenting. I'm repenting of known sins and unknown sins because I don't want anything to obstruct my flow. Amen. I have a spiritual friend that I talk to each and every day, and we talk about the Lord and talk about the word. Amen. You got to find your rhythm. You got to find your rhythm. Amen. I like what I'm hearing here. Amen. My sister says 8 a.m., 8:55 a.m. prayer call. Read her word. Make 12-step meeting. That's your flow. Absolutely. Amen. Mother Sam said participating in reading the Bible plan. Absolutely. That's part of your flow. Amen. Katrina said prayer, reading the word, staying connected to this ministry, constantly seeking God. Amen. Hallelujah. That's right. Your flow. Amen. Keisha said waking up and say good morning to God. Listen to scriptures while I'm driving to work. Amen. On the prayer call, on the broadcast. Amen. Absolutely. That's your flow. Amen. Another part of my flow, that's natural flows of my life as well. Amen. Part of my flow, amen, is spending time with my spouse. That's part of my flow. Amen. Making sure we're having dates. Amen. You know, also part of my flow is walking in the morning. Walking in the morning, exercising, praise God. That's a part of my flow. Amen. So you got to find your rhythm, your daily rhythm that keeps you in the flow, that produce, amen, spiritual maturity. Amen. That produce, amen, you know, a healthy lifestyle, that produce, amen, healthy relationships. Amen. You got to establish your daily life rhythm, your daily life rhythm that keeps you in the flow of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Sister Love said, thank God for waking me up and getting ready for the broadcast. Absolutely. Now, I'm getting ready to pray. I want to say happy birthday to Mother Sam again. Amen. God bless you. Amen. We're so excited about what God is doing in your life and giving your life. And we're so excited about what you're allowing God to do to bless the lives of others. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Yes, yes, yes. Thank you. All right, let's pray. Father, in Jesus' name, I thank you for your goodness and your mercy and your grace and your loving kindness. We worship you. We worship and adore your name. Hallelujah. We love you more than anything. And we thank you for the flow of the Spirit that lives inside of us. It will be impossible to live for you, God, without the deposit and the flow of your Spirit. So Holy Spirit, forgive us. Forgive us for quenching you. Forgive us for grieving you. Have mercy on us. Wash us in the precious blood of Jesus. And Holy Spirit, help us to be more conscious of how you're flowing in our lives. Help us to be more responsive, Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, have your way in our lives. Help us to establish the daily rhythm that you want us to establish in our lives so that we stay connected, that we stay collaborating with you, that you continue to flow in us and through us. You're so very vital to us. We need you more than our breath. We need you more than our blood. We need you. Without you, we can do nothing. So Holy Spirit, we thank you for being a perfect gentleman. We thank you for never forcing us. We thank you for never leaving us nor forsaking us. Holy Spirit, we value your presence. And I pray for all my partners on here that you would help them to establish a life rhythm, that you would direct all of us in a life rhythm that keeps us connected to you, that keeps us flowing in you. Holy Spirit, work in us that which is well-pleasing in the sight of the Father, and help us to establish those flows in every area of our lives, our relationship flow, our marriage flow, our money flow, our health flow, our ministry flow, our business flow, our career flow. Holy Spirit, live in us, reign in us, Holy Spirit. We give you the right of way, and we thank you for your partnership in our lives. We love you. We thank you. We give you glory and honor and praise. And I pray that you continue to bless Diane, continue to bless May, continue to bless Barbara Hill, continue to bless, Lord, those who may be struggling with their health. I pray for healing and strength for them. I pray, Lord God, for a blessing on Mother Sam on her beautiful birthday, Father. I pray, God, for your people. I pray, God, for their families. I pray that you bless them and save them and heal them and deliver them. I pray, God, that you prosper us in this day. Help us to stay in the flow. Help us to stay engaged with you. And help us, Lord God, to allow you to lead us in every way. We know your way is always best because your way is always better. We love you. We bless you. We praise you. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. All right, everybody, you guys be blessed and have a supernatural day in Jesus' name, and stay in the flow.